Hello and greetings from Iceland. Yet again, I have some big news, or one more Icelandic volcano that I can definitely put on my list of volcanoes that are somewhere in the process of getting ready to erupt or confirmed land uplift. And this could probably be the most unexpected entry of the year. And this is not one of these simple systems, you know, magma, pressure and puff. This is the Torfajökull area, named after Torfajökull glacier, that only covers a small portion of what is most likely the largest caldera in Iceland. It is however a bit hard to see its outlines, and it's not that many decades ago since scientists realized that this area is in fact a giant caldera complex. And since then, the area has been studied extensively, since its meaning is significant for the bigger blueprint of the plumbing system under Iceland. The system itself is an independent rhyolite system, but it has this complicated connection with other volcanic systems, like it's closely connected to the Bárðabunga hotspot, and the Bárðabunga system seems to have penetrated the Torfajökull system. And some experts say that it seems as the Torfajökull system doesn't have a will on its own. West from Torfajökull, there is another system, and that system is somehow connected to the Hekla volcano. Like Bárðabunga, it is putting pressure on the Torfajökull system and causing eruptions there. And this makes Torfajökull possibly the most complex geological phenomenon that can be found in Iceland. And this caldera can perhaps best be described as chaotic conflicts between different systems on volcanic junctions. And what we find on the surface is a spectacular landscape and Iceland's largest geothermal area, about 150 square kilometers. At least 12 eruptions have occurred here in the last 9,000 years. Four of them started with explosions. And the last significant eruption was shortly before the settlement of Iceland, and the Bárðabunga system erupted as well back then. And the last known eruption was in the year 1477, so it is big news that this giant caldera seems to be waking up after all this time. But it may not be a coincidence. The Vatnafjöll system to the west was shaking last year, obviously very much alive, just like Bárðabunga, that is still reloading after the 2014 eruption. And just recently I made a video about the earthquake swarm in Torfajökull that occurred right after a strong earthquake in Bárðabunga, so I was wondering about the connection in that video. And the earthquakes in Torfajökull back then, they were at very little depth, and the land uplift since June is 4 centimeters. And how long do we have to wait? And how will an eruption there play out? That is of course the big question. There are many experts in Iceland and luckily they don't always agree. Otherwise it would be no fun to talk about this. And the discussion about this started with a rather lively statement from a volcanologist. He said that an eruption could start there at any moment and it could even be explosive, and tell us clearly that it's time to sell our airline stocks. And I believe him, but I do also believe the other experts who say that there is no reason to make some fuss about this. We could have to wait for a long time, and if it would erupt, it could just as well be a cute little tourist eruption. So I did some browsing and found some good articles about this area, and I even found a scientist who believes that this area is actually above the hotspot under Iceland, but not Bárðabunga. That has been and still is the official hotspot, and scientists do not agree on this, and it is far above my general understanding in geology to even try to dive into it. But the comment section is a good place to share information as always, and I'm leaving a link to this scientist who stirred things up a bit when he pointed out that the Torfajökull system could be the center of volcanism in Iceland. But what I do however know is that from time to time the Earth's mantle squeezes out huge quantities of magma, unlike anything witnessed in historic times, and Bárðabunga is one of those systems that delivers such quantities. And also the next door Grímsvötn system, and even the Katla system. And we don't have to zoom deep into a satellite photo to see the plate boundaries, and the wasteland around those systems, or the devastation. And the last major eruption in Iceland occurred in 1784, and the interval between such events is 300 to 400 years. So, statistically, there is no reason to expect any major event soon, although I would not bet on it. This land uplift on the highlands is not going to change anything as for tourism in the region. The Laugavegur hiking trail remains open, and everything is quiet by Katla volcano, so it's no reason to get worried, but every reason to always be well connected to good information sources, especially when it comes to highland trips. And what does this mean for my channel? I expect that I will need to do several updates from this region in the coming weeks and months. And that means the more footage I have, the better updates I can deliver. And I have to admit, although I have been up there a few times, I've never had the best weather conditions for photography. And I've never been up there after I got a drone. So, to be honest, I don't have a lot of footage from there. So, I have this big tour coming up now. I just got my car back yesterday from repair. The exhaust system got a bit exhausted after some Icelandic trails. That's been fixed now, so I'm getting ready for the road, charging all batteries. And this tour I'm doing now will be organized around weather and light conditions. I have a long list of places to visit. Some of them are categorized as must-have footage to document some of the ongoing events, no matter how the weather will be. Like, I desperately need footage from the earthquake region by Langjökull Glacier that has been shaking recently. And I really want to go to the Torfajökull region, but only if I'm sure to get good weather, so I can bring back some color fantasy from there. Especially since I will have to drive over many rivers like this, so I'm hoping that Mother Nature will give me some good photo conditions. So this will be my last update before I hit the road. I will do updates from the road if I need to. I will also go to Reykjavík, and it is my plan to go to the mountain Keilir with the thermal drone and fly around the recently deceased volcano on the Reykjanes Peninsula. But first and foremost, I will be chasing light, hoping to get lucky from time to time. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.